Tune in to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab, where we have episode 3 with DevOps for Java Shops. So tune in to see what we do next with feature flags and GitHub Actions. Welcome back to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. We're going to kick off our series, DevOps for Java Shops. We're back with episode 3, and we're welcoming back Brian Benz. Welcome, Brian.
Greetings. Glad to be here.
Great to have you back. We have Bit joining us on this episode as well. He's very interested to see how this app is going to come about. And in this one, we're going to talk about our Java app deployment into Azure App Service, and we're going to complete that GitHub action and get that full end-to-end development into our application.
Yep, great. Yeah, in the last episode, I did a build which completely failed. And then we actually deployed out to Azure, but that's not going to work either. So this is what the app is supposed to look like here on my screen. It's supposed to look like this. But if I go into our GitHub repo, if you see here, it deployed and it's got a green check mark. It's successfully deployed to devopslabbb.azurewebsites.net. But when I click here, you get an error message. So this is what the error message looks like. It's just telling you that the application is not working. And I can do something kind of cool here. I can go to devopslabbb.azurewebsites.net, but I can also add a SCM here. So devopslabbb.scm.azurewebsites.net. And this works for any Azure app service. And it creates a little environment called Kudu for you. And inside of Kudu, you can check out your site. You can see the jar file did indeed deploy. So the GitHub action here, when I go in, it's not lying. It did deploy. It did actually deploy to my app. App service using app.jar, which is my Java file. However, it's missing an important part. So if we actually go back in and I refresh my dashboard on Azure, you'll see that DevOps Lab BB is the app service. And inside the configuration, there's something I need to set up. So this is like a real world situation where you would have something like a database connection or something else. So the app is actually deployed. The jar file is there and it's running, but the application is failing because you haven't set up the configuration yet. What you need to do there is actually just set up a new application setting. And in this case, it's called app configuration connection string. If you recall, in the first episode, I talked about feature flags using our Azure app configuration service. And inside those feature flags, there's a connection string that you get provided with. And that connection string can be used anywhere. You still have to connect your application to the actual feature flag manager and app configuration through some kind of connection string. And in this case, the app is set up to use this app configuration connection string to point to the server. So it's actually going to connect to that feature flag service. It's updating the web app right now. So now, when I actually go back into my application here, we still see an error. But it's a different error now. And this is a good error because if we type welcome, we see it. There we go. Yay. So this is the original application that I already had working. This is the application that we just created at devopslabbb.azurewebsites.net. It's fully running now just by adding that connection string. If I go into the feature manager now, here's the cool part. I can turn off the feature flag. I mentioned before, this feature flag can be set and it can connect to any kind of application running on Azure, not running on Azure. It'll actually remove Bit from here, but it'll also remove Bit from our old application as well. There we go. So the idea here is you can create one feature flag that actually controls, multiple applications. So if you want, if you've got 12 different applications, one's running on App Service, one's running on Kubernetes, one's running on AWS, one's running on local, on-prem, all you have to do is press that button or set up a time window or set up a geographic location. And all of those features will be enabled or disabled depending on your settings when you change the feature manager.
That's awesome, because I think most of our customers are not entirely in Azure. They're either in a hybrid environment where they're running on-prem, another cloud. So this is perfect. And they probably have applications running across multiple data centers in Azure or anywhere else. And again, we see a lot of people running, you said it, Brian, in applications in Azure Web Apps, AKS, and all sorts of places. So this is really cool. It's great to see that we can affect our app in multiple locations on multiple services and leverage feature flags.
Right. Yeah. Before feature flags, you would have to deploy a new version of the application somewhere else, kind of figure out how to deploy and link to that application and all the other stuff. So this is a great way to do that. For those of you who want to follow along at home, you can find all of the demos and the code that I use today and a step-by-step instructions at DevOps for Java Shops. So akka.ms/DevOps for Java Shops.
Awesome. Thank you, Brian. And for everyone out there, we will have this link up here for you. We'll also put it in the show notes. So please go out, give it a shot, enable some feature flags, get your application to a GitHub Action and see what you can do with it. And put some stuff in the comments about the cool things you've done with your apps and feature flags. So thank you everyone for tuning in and stay tuned. We might have Brian Benz back for another episode here on the DevOps Lab.